up. I want to lift up verse number 24. I want to preach from a parable today. And this particular parable, you have it on your smart device or your Bible. There's the English Standard Version on the screens, and I'm going to be reading from the English Standard Version out of my book here. Once you have Matthew's Gospel chapter 13, starting at verse number 24, it's actually verse number 24 through verse number 30. And here's the word of the Lord, amen. Word of the Lord for the people of God. You have it, say amen. Amen. Here's what the word of God says. He put another parable before them, saying, the kingdom of heaven may be compared to a man who sowed good seed in his field. But while his men were sleeping, his enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. So when the plants came up when the plants came up and bore grain, then the weeds appeared also. And the servants of the master of the house came and said to him, Master, did you not sow good seed in your field? How then does it have weeds? And he said to them, well, an enemy has done this. So the servant said to him, well, then you want us to go out and gather them? But he said, no, lest in gathering the weeds, you root up the wheat among with them. Let both grow together until the harvest. And at harvest time, I will tell the reapers, gather the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be gather the weeds first and bind them in bundles to be burned, but gather the wheat into my barn. I want to preach today from this parable by your prayers and God's help. I want to talk about wheat and weeds. Wheat and weeds. Why don't you look at someone on your row and look at them straight in the eye and say, the preacher wants to talk about. Y'all didn't do that. Look at somebody on your row and say, the preacher wants to talk about. Wheat and weeds. Amen. That's what I want to talk about for just a few moments on today. Brothers and sisters, among many parables, this is the parable of Jesus Christ. Must I say, brothers and sisters, in a nutshell, a parable is literally a laying down alongside. It is a story that gives an example of a meaning of what the spokesman is trying to say. In other words, brothers and sisters, there's another way they would describe parables as it has earthly tone, but it has a spiritual meaning. It is a story that parallels to lay down alongside something in order to get people to understand the big entire picture. And ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, it is Jesus Christ here who is found in Matthew's Gospel chapter 13 speaking this particular parable. Now, must I say, brothers and sisters, that when you read these verses from verse number 24 through verse number 30, you will discover that there is a man that Jesus talks about. And Jesus talks about the kingdom of heaven being compared to a man who sowed good seed. But when he sowed good seed in his field, it was while he was not attentive, while he was actually sleeping in the night, the enemy came and sowed weeds among his seed. It goes on to understand that when all of a sudden, when it came up and it's time for the plants to come up, the servants of the man noticed that there was wheat growing, but there was also weeds growing in the wheat. It sparks conversation between the man and his servants, because when his servants came and said, hey, we thought you planted wheat. Now, why in the world are weeds coming up among your wheat? He said, well, what happened is while we were asleep, it was a work of the enemy, that Satan himself came and he planted weeds in my field. They said, "Well, listen, we are posse together, and we'll go and pull up that what the Satan has planted or the enemy has planted." He said, "No. But because the danger is what you don't understand is deep down in the ground, that what actually happens is the wheat is down there in the root, but what the weeds do is the weeds in their roots will tie themselves around the roots of the wheat. And so if you go out there messing with it, what happens is you're trying to pull up weeds and it's going to be killing wheat. Because the weeds have connected themselves under the ground to the wheat. So he said, just leave it alone. And if you just leave it alone, in the last day, when we harvest the crop, the Lord of the harvest will separate then, in King James Version, the wheat from the tare. Ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, and I looked at this particular passage of scripture, and in my time of meditation and my time of talking to God, I discovered that he talks about wheat and weeds. And this passage literally talks about the plot of Satan. The plot of Satan. If you're writing anything down, write that down. It talks about the plot of Satan. And the plot of Satan is to come and plot anytime God has planted. Don't miss that. Let me say that again. That it is the motives of Satan and it is the actions of Satan to always plot whenever God has planted. So therefore, that means if God has planted seed in you, or planted good seed in you, it is Satan's job to plot against your seed. All right, okay, this is a slow crowd, okay? Let me do this again. I say if God has planted something good in you or something good is going to come out of you, or something good God has planted in you to come out of you and to birth out of you, out of your life, it is always the job of Satan to come in secretly and plot against what God has planted. Ladies and gentlemen, in this passage, you see the plot of Satan in verse number 25 in particular, because in this particular verse, it would tell you, brothers and sisters, that it was then, the text says, but while his men were sleeping, the enemy came and sowed weeds among the wheat. The enemy came and sowed weeds among wheat, ladies and gentlemen. It is the plot of Satan. But then the text also talks about there are the pretenders in the soil. There is also the pretenders in the soil. That's also verse number 25, because this is what it says. It says that when it came and sowed weeds among the wheat and went away. In other words, they sowed those weeds there, and the weeds would come up, but they would come up camouflaged as if they are wheat. Ladies and gentlemen, because it is there are the pretenders of the soil, weeds acting as if they are wheat. But ladies and gentlemen, you have to be careful, because when you have the plot of Satan, what is the plot of Satan? The plot of Satan, again, let me remind you, is the plot on top of what God has planted. And when he plots on top of what God has planted, Sister Love, what he does is then that which he has planted, that which Satan has planted, becomes pretenders of the soil. So you therefore tells you to understand, don't ever, brothers and sisters, be naive so much to whereas you think that everything that is growing around you is of God. that everything that pops up around you is godly planted. I can't get no help in here early, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, because I want to let you know it can be an illusion of Satan. Satan, in a season that you're trying to make some decisions for your life and make some decisions for yourself, Satan, amen, can pop some weeds up in your life that looks like wheat, and you'll think it's a blessing, but actually it's a burden. You think that it is a bountiful blessing, and it is actually a barrier in order to suffocate you in your life and suffocate the life out of you. Are you understanding what I'm trying to tell you? You got to be careful, ladies and gentlemen, because it is the plot of Satan, but then it is the pretenders in the soil. And don't get caught up on that, because, brothers and sisters, at the end of the day and at the end of the text, it is the power of the seed. It is the power of the seed. Here's the whole story, ladies and gentlemen, that at the end of the day, what God planted, or what was planted by the Lord, ladies and gentlemen, could not be stopped. Because it was the power of the seed, and it was the power in the seed, ladies and gentlemen, don't miss this, because according to verse number 26, it said, and when the plants came up, that in spite of the plot and in spite of the pretenders, the plants still came up. And I want to deal with this for just a moment, if you allow me just to deal with this, because there's three things I want to share with you about the seed. There's three things I want to share with you about the seed, because if the plant came up, it turns my attention to the seed. What about the seed? What is there so much about the seed? Well, I would suggest there is, Brother Marsh, three things about the seeds we need to remember. Well, here it is. Number one, the first thing you need to understand about the seed is, number one, the seed had the capacity to flourish. Yeah. See, I often say this whenever I'm talking about mustard seeds, or when I'm talking about seeds, that a seed, you can't stop a seed from being a seed, because only thing a seed know how to do is be a seed. And a seed don't know how to do nothing but produce what it is. And so really, once you put a seed in the ground or plant a seed in something, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, that seed possesses what it needs on the inside of it in order for it to produce. Okay. Let me say that again. The seed already possesses on the inside of it what it needs in order to produce. If it is to produce oranges, it's going to produce oranges. If it needs to produce apples, it's going to produce apples. Are y'all understanding what I'm saying? Because you can't stop a seed from being a seed. And three things you need to know about a seed is that the seed, watch this, had the capacity to flourish. It had the capacity to flourish. Let me talk to y'all just for a minute, because when you look at verse number 26 says it like this, and so the plants came up. But if you have a King James Bible in the King James Version, it says this, but who has a King James? All right, your King James says but, am I right? Your verse number 26, your King James says, but that in spite of the plot and in spite of the poison that has been planted, verse 26 says in King James, but, and the but is followed by, in that verse 26, King James, and it sprouted up. It says sprouted up. In other words, in spite of the plot, in spite of the pretender, in spite of the poison that was planted, brothers and sisters, the seed had the capacity to flourish. Y'all don't understand what I'm saying, because what it's saying here is that the seed still sprung up, or the seed, it popped up. Look at somebody and say, it popped up. Which ought to tell you this. Number one, let me go ahead and clear the air, brothers and sisters. I'm not in here talking about seeds. I'm really talking about you. Because some of y'all gonna leave here today thinking pastor was talking about seeds, and really I was talking a parable to try to help you understand more about yourself, because you're so busy crying about who plotting against you and everything that is going wrong with you and everything that is going wrong around you, and don't realize that God has put a but in your life. And a but in English literature, but will cancel out everything that happened before. Y'all don't hear me? But cancels out the fact that you are divorced. But cancels out the fact that you've lost your job. But cancels out that you're broke. But cancels out the fact of that you're living with your mama. But cancels out the fact of that you can't hardly pay your bills. But cancels out the fact, because what comes not behind the but matters, but what comes now in front of the but matters. Because God has a tendency to put a but in all of our lives. I am tired, but I'm still making it. I am upset, but God is gonna give me joy. I am broke, but God is still paying my bills. I am going through right now, but I'm going to come out. I am having the hardest time of my life, but God is gonna make a way. Thank God that I've had some rough stuff to happen to me. Enemies are plotting against me, but God will lift up a standard against my enemy. You don't hear me here? Why don't you take about 30 seconds to thank God for the but in your life? Not what happened, but what God has put on the front end, what is getting ready to happen. Because when you understand that the seed had the capacity to flourish, won't you tell somebody, I'm still flourishing, I'm still flourishing. Because the seed that was planted, Shakira, couldn't stay down.
That's right.
Right there in the enemy's face. Verse 26 says, it popped up. I said, right there in front of the enemy who was there to camouflage and stop it and block it and suffocate it, it sprouted up. It popped up. And verse number 26 says, not only did it pop up, but then it produced. Because it was always the goal of the weeds to hinder productivity. Amen. And some of you think that the weed ain't bought. Watch this. Because see, the weed wasn't touching the wheat. Watch this. On top of the ground. But it was wrapped around the wheat under the ground in order to suffocate it in the dark. To suffocate it behind the scenes. And some of you today, you even know people who have set up your demise, and people who have plotted against you. Don't look at me in that tone of voice, because some of y'all work with them. You gotta go to school with them. Some of y'all live with them. Some of y'all go to church with them. And you know that they have plotted, but listen, you done spent so much time talking about the plot, you don't realize you still producing. And sometimes you ain't gotta fight your enemy, you ain't gotta tell your enemy that I know who you are. No, all you gotta do is just keep producing. Because according to verse number 26, and it sprouted up and it produced fruit. Y'all don't hear me? And you gotta understand, sometimes the greatest response to the enemy's plot is just keep producing. Just keep getting your hair done, keep getting your nails done, keep getting your feet pedicured, keep putting on the best outfit. Y'all don't understand what I'm saying. Keep on going to work, keep on smelling good, go put your best suit on, go get your hair cut. Y'all don't hear me today? Sometimes that's the best thing for the enemy, to show the enemy, in spite of what you're doing, you ain't stopped me yet. I'm still standing, I'm still going to work, I'm still raising my children, I'm still putting gas in my car, I'm still going to church, and I'm still praising his name. I ain't lost my joy. I might be going through a struggle, but I'm still here. Sometime if you'll just keep on producing, that's all the enemy needs to know he's been defeated. Whoa, want you to nudge your neighbor with your elbow and say, keep producing, keep producing, keep producing. Because weeds are designed to kill your productivity. But won't you tell your neighbor right now, still I rise, still I rise, still I rise, still I rise. They can get on top of me, but still I rise. They can try to put a detour in my way, but I still, God has made my mountain a stepping stone. Amen. How many of y'all know the difference between a stumbling block and a stepping stone? The difference between a stumbling block and a stepping stone is how high you willing to lift your leg. And some of us have learned how to lift our legs just a little higher to step over the traps that the enemy then put in your way. Look, hey, hey, nudge your neighbor, say, lift your leg higher. You can get over it. You'll get over it. I got 12 minutes. I'm always reminded, Sister Brown, Sister Queen, I'm always reminded, Deacon Robinson, of the story of the little boy who went to Toys R Us. And this is long before Toys R Us ever closed. But Colton, he went to Toys R Us. It was right around Christmas time. Mama's going to buy him some toys, Mother Burns. And all of a sudden, he walked down the aisle and he saw this dummy doll. And the dummy doll was some other kid had left it in the middle of the aisle. So Deacon Huntley, he walked down there, looked at the dummy doll, walked around the dummy doll, and the dummy doll was just sitting there. So what he did, Deacon Johnson, he slapped the doll, and the doll came back up. He took his fist and hit the doll, and the doll came back up. By that time, the manager of the toy department is now looking down the aisle at him, and he's now saying, well, let me do something else. He takes the doll deep, and he puts the doll in a headlock and takes it down and pins it down to the ground and counts to 10. He jumps up, and the doll bounces back up. So by this time, he takes his leg like he's Randy Savage, and he now goes across the doll, and he holds and pins him down, and finally gets up, and the doll bounces back up. By this time, the manager then had all he can have. And so now he goes down the aisle, looks at the little boy, and say, young boy, do you understand why every time you slap the doll, it bounced back up? Every time you hit the doll, it bounced back up. Every time you pin the doll down, it bounced back up. Every time you punch the doll and lay on top of it, and he said, and bounce back up. You done karate chop it, and it bounced back up. And the little boy said, I don't know, sir, but evidently it's something on the inside of the doll. Come here just for a second. Won't you serve your enemy the notice of the reason why you keep bouncing back and the reason why you keep coming back every time the enemy tries to stop you? Why don't you serve notice on the enemy that it's really because there's something on the inside of me that gives me the ability to bounce back every time the enemy thinks he has me down? Lord have mercy. Where's my bounce back people? My bounce back people that I ain't even supposed to be here, but I bounce back. I ain't even supposed to be able to do what I'm doing, but I bounce back. And ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, it's because when you look at this text, the seed had the capacity to flourish. But then, secondly, the seed had the confidence of the farmer. Because here it is, when the servants came and said, well, you want us to go out there and pluck up all the weeds? They say, we will gang up together and we'll go out there and we will get them weeds out of the way. And they say, the enemy did this. Oh, yo, no, we'll go out there and take it. And watch this. The seed had the confidence of the farmer. Because this is what the farmer said. He said, leave them alone. Because let the weeds grow up around my wheat. Because the farmer has confidence in the seed. His attention ain't on what the weeds are doing. He has confidence, Lord help me here today, to let, watch this, them grow together. That the higher the weeds get, the stronger the seed gets. Okay, this is wrong sermon, wrong church. Let me do it again. I say, the thicker the weeds get, the more strength the seed gets. He say, I don't want you to remove what the enemy planted. Let it stay there. Let her go to work with it every day. Huh? Let him come to church with it every Sunday. Let him go home to it every night. I can't get no help in here. Because somebody is praying for God to remove what the enemy has plotted and planted. And he says, no, because I got confidence in you that really is going to help you. Y'all don't hear me. I say, he knows that what is in you is stronger than what's coming after you. Okay. Y'all, somebody on your other side of you missed it. Let me say it again. He don't have to take you out of situations. He knows you have what it takes to get through it. You saying, Lord, get me out. He said, no, I'm going to leave you in. Because you don't realize as a seed, you got what it takes to get all the way through it. You've been crying, but you're making it through it. Huh? You've been going through heartache, heartbreak, but you're making it through it. The last time the enemy plotted on you, it was just a plot. It was not a period, but it was only a comma. It was just something that you had to go through temporary. And now you're on the other side of it. And you ought to thank God that a lot of times Jesus got more confidence in you than you got in yourself. And if you're still in the middle of some stuff right now that the enemy done plotted against you, stay right there and change your mindset and say, he got confidence in me. Same kind of confidence he had in Job. When Satan came to Job and came to God and said, let me have him. Take the hedge away from him. Let me tell you what God said. I got enough confidence in him that if I allow you to take his stuff, you won't steal his soul. You can take his stuff, but you won't steal his shout. He gonna stand up and say, the Lord gives and the Lord takes away, and blessed be the name, y'all ain't saying nothing, of the Lord, because God had confidence. His wife got crazy, but he said, that's all right. All the days of my appointed time, I will wait until my change come. I say, look at your neighbor right now and say, thank God he got confidence in me. Thank God he trusted me with this level of foolishness. Thank God he trusted me with this level of aggravation. Thank God he trusted me with this level of trial. He got confidence. Look at your neighbor and say, you better pass too. You better pass the test. You better not let the enemy knock you off your guard. You better not let what's happening to you steal your joy. You better not let your struggle stress you. I say, get your shout back. Because God got enough confidence in you to leave you in the middle of what you're in the middle of. And I'm grateful today that as many times as I prayed that my Lord would move me, take me out of this, take me out of that, I heard the Lord saying, I'm trusting you with this. I'm trusting. I'm trusting you need this. You to build your integrity, to build your endurance, I'm talking to somebody. I say, he said, you need this. Yeah, but put your resignation down, throw it in the drawer, rip it up while you're trying to resign too soon. You need this. How dare you gonna resign early when you want to be promoted? You can't be promoted in a powder too. There's some stuff you got to take, and there's some things you got to put up with. I'm talking too much for you. Am I talking too much? Y'all ready for me to shut up? No. I'm gonna shut up. I'm gonna sit down. Yeah. In order to reach your goal, in order to reach your potential, in order to reach your vision, you got to go through plots on this level so you can be ready for the devil on that level. You don't hear me here today. Oh, but I thank God. I thank God. I thank God. I thank God. I thank God today, because what we know about the seed, we understand the seeds had the capacity to flourish. The seed had the confidence of the farmer. But lastly, here it is. The seed had a cause for the future. I say the seed had a cause for the future. You don't hear me. I said it again for you. That's it. That's all I got. The seed had a cause. The word cause means purpose. The seed had a cause, or it had a purpose for the future. That the reason, here we go, y'all ready? And I'm sitting down. That the enemy was attacking the seed because of the purpose in the seed. That the seed wasn't going to be a seed forever. That what the enemy knew is that he had to plot, he had to perpetrate and try to block you before you became bread. Because what you're going through right now very well ain't got nothing to do with you. Because I don't eat you in the infancy.
That's right.
So the plot is to kill the seed in its infancy. Before you birth and become what you're going to become, and more than just one person be able to partake from you. So now, the devil should have stopped you before you got to church today. Because now you understand why he's fighting you so bad. Now you understand why his plots are so great. And now you understand why he just won't give up. Why he knows your address and won't lose your telephone number. Yeah, now you know why he won't leave your address. I'll tell you why. It's because he's looking at your future. And since he's looking at your future, he wanna stop you in the infancy. In other words, he wanna stop you while you're small. Because he don't want you to get big as you're gonna get. Y'all ain't going nowhere, huh? Lord, where's my people that know that where you are ain't where you're going to be? Huh? That was a reason to nudge your neighbor right then and say, this ain't the end of my story. The devil ain't intimidated by what you got now. I say the devil ain't intimidated by what you possess right now. But what he's intimidated by what you are going to become. Because what you're going to become is much greater than what you are. Why I gotta tell y'all this and you act like you don't know this? In other words, I don't want no sesame seed from McDonald's. I want the whole bun. Because, I can't feed my children no sesame seed on top of no Big Mac. But if I ever get the bread that the seed comes from, have I got a witness in here? I can can do a whole lot more with the bread than I can from the wheat of the seeds. Have I got any help in here? And that's all I'm trying to tell you as I take my seat, is that you got greater in front of you. And I heard the farmer saying, so that's why I'm going to let the wheat and the tare, I'm going to let the wheat and the weeds grow together, because in the last day, he said, I'll do the separating. Do I have a witness in here? He said, I'll do the separating when you finally grow up and when you finally birth and be what you're designed to be. Do I have any witnesses in here? So that's why I praise God for every mountain, and I thank God for every valley, and I thank God for every struggle that he's brought me through. I'm trying to get out of here. Won't you nudge your neighbor and say, he's really trying to go? Because if I never had a problem, how would I know that God can solve it? And how could I know what faith in God's word can do? Can I close by saying, through it all, I've learned to trust in Jesus. Through it all, I've learned to trust in God and take him at his word. Do I have any witnesses in here? So thank God that God is letting you grow with your enemies all around you. He's letting you grow with your haters hating on you. But you know what I told myself early this morning? This is what I told myself. I said, self, I believe I'm gonna run on and see what the end's gonna be. I believe I'm gonna pick up my face and put a praise on my lips, and I'm gonna clap my hands and tell the Lord thank you, because now that you didn't make the enemies leave me, now that you let them go along with me, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better, so much better. Wrap your arm around your neighbor and say, I got a testimony. I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better. Up in the balcony, shake somebody's hand and say, I'm stronger, I'm wiser, I'm better. And the law is gonna take care of me. The law is gonna see about me. The law. Doors of the church is open.